Self-marriage is when a person pretty much makes a commitment to value themselves, love themselves. I decided maybe after my last relationship about a decade ago, I've always had this yearning to please me no matter what relationship I've been in. And after I got out of that last relationship, I just told myself, you know what? I don't think couple type of monogamous relationship or marriage is for me. My name is Mika. I'm from Atlanta, Georgia. I moved to Tampa about 8 years ago, and I own my own business in Tampa, Classic Sassy Styles. I'm a master cosmetologist. I used to have this weird saying before I realized I actually wanted to marry myself. I used to have this weird saying that I didn't want to cheat on myself. I didn't want to date other people because I felt like I was cheating on myself. I just have this thing where I treat myself really, really good. You know, I treat myself really well. And that's one of the questions that is pretty much asked in the process of deciding whether someone would want to marry themselves is, you know, if you were with someone who treated you the way you treated yourself, would you still want to be with that person? And so in the way I think of it is, who can treat me better than I treat myself? The experience was pretty much that of any woman who is marrying a man or at a wedding in a regular traditional marriage. So the same feelings that any woman would have, I had those feelings. I felt like I had cold feet. I felt nervous, emotionally overwhelmed. I felt like wanting to cry. I felt like leaving me at the altar, giving up, canceling the whole thing and just saying forget it. But I pushed through. I pushed through it. I know it's non-traditional, unconventional, but I went on and pushed through it. Actually, they're taking it a lot better than I would have thought. Although I try to live my life not worried about what other people think of me, it led me to this decision, this lifelong decision I just made. I try not to really care what people think of me, especially in a negative way. But surprisingly, I have influenced a lot of my friends and loved ones in a very positive way. And that's a little bit surprising. And at the same time, I think I've woken up some things in themselves. They may not actually have a full ceremony, but I think they walked away with something and said, you know what, that's a good idea. Put yourself first. All my marriage friends, they all came to me and said, Mika, you know what? I can't be a good wife to my husband or my kids unless I put me first and love me first. And I think that's what it done for my loved ones. So my vows to myself was a promise that I made to myself to always give myself the best part of me, to be my best friend. I promise to accept myself throughout changing and evolving. I promise to respect myself and as my own person, you know. I promise to accept my own interests, my own desires and feelings and dreams. I promise to finally to love myself first and to put myself first no matter what, the good times, bad times, for better or worse. I promise to prioritize myself no matter what relationships I have with other people. That's my vow to myself. I promise to love me and love me first. To me, it's important because these are vows that I made in front of an audience, in front of other people, to let other people know I'm very serious about this lifestyle choice that I've made for me. So the ceremony meant a lot, really, to me.
I like the concept of maintaining balance in nature between male and female. Although I am marrying myself, I truly believe in life and the cycle of life. I customized my ring based on that concept. It is an ankh, the key of life, an ancient Egyptian hieroglyphic symbol. The top of the ring is a teardrop-shaped loop. That part represents the female, and the bottom represents the male. It is based on feminine principles of nature, spirituality, and peace.
It's such a great feeling. You know, this type of lifestyle leads to a happier life, if you ask me. Again, even for those people who are into coupledom, we call it coupledom, or if you are into having someone, at the end of the day, you have to love yourself first. To me, I truly believe loving self first allows you to give love horizontally to someone else. I've always saw myself as an older woman married. You know, I think I've been to a few weddings where women have married in their 50s and 60s, and they were beautiful brides. And I've always said, you know, I see myself doing that one day. So there's a chance I could marry later on in life, but that man has to know that I am priority. He is priority in his own world. He is an individual. I am priority in my own world, and he will be sharing me with me. At the end of the day, so yeah. I did and I didn't at the same time. I did and I didn't. So I took myself to a spa, resort spa, where clothes are optional. So it was just a very free place mentally for me. I took myself there just to kind of relax and enjoy the moment of being with me. I am my first love. I am my lover. That is also a commitment. In sologamy is pretty much your first. You are your lover, you know. And so I had to embrace that at the consummation of my marriage. I embrace that I am. I complete me. I don't want nobody but you, baby. You're something else, and you know. True, and don't try to hide it now. You hold it down.